What's going on, guys? I'm Landon from Shoewear, and today we're putting the newest models from Damian Lillard and Donovan Mitchell's shoe lines with Adidas head-to-head to see how they compare. So really quickly, I do want to say, if this is your first time checking us out, feel free to drop a follow or subscribe wherever you're watching, and go ahead and give this video a like. We would greatly appreciate that. But now let's go ahead and do a quick rundown for the box and the price. So the Dame 7s do come in like a black box with kind of a bunch of pink lines just running across it with his player logo kind of stenciled in on top. While the Don 3s come in a red box with that spider logo kind of blown up, you know, since his nickname is Spider Mitchell. But for pricing, we actually do have an even matchup for these today, because both shoes are going to be retailing for $110. So we're looking at some more affordable options for basketball shoes today, just compared to across the field. So that's always going to be nice. But that covers the box and price for these. So now let's go ahead and get into the shoes. All right, so before I dive into the performance comparison, I do kind of want to hit on the appearance for each of these shoes first really quick. So starting off with the colorways, we do have another similarity there, because today we're checking out the Say Cheese color scheme for both of these shoes. So you're going to see a camera kind of show up on the band over the laces on that Don issue 3 model, and then you can see the same camera kind of show up faintly on the upper for the Dame 7s as well. But you know, as far as the appearance goes, I do think the overall look to the Dame 7s is just a little bit better, just because, you know, it has a little more going on. You do have a patch on the outside of that shoe with the three stripes on there, obviously for Adidas. And then that same patch shows up on the inside with his studio nickname, Dame Dala, on there as well. But that's going to be because whenever Dame isn't hitting, you know, buzzer beaters on your favorite NBA team, you could probably find him in the booth recording, because he is sort of like a part-time recording artist, somewhat of a rapper, and, you know, a solid one at that. He's even done some recordings and songs with Lil Wayne, DDG, and, you know, some other names out there. So I think that's a pretty cool little hobby that he has. But one knock on the Dame 7 is that they didn't really switch up a ton from last year's Dame 6 model, whereas the Don 3 made a bunch of noticeable changes. The only issue is that I'm not really a huge fan of the changes that they did make, but I'll go ahead and move on from the appearance section, and now we'll go ahead and look at how each of these shoes hold up on the court. All right, so now getting more into the performance and the material comparison, I'll start off with the cushioning first. So as displayed on the midsole, both of these shoes have a light strike midsole that runs throughout the entire shoe. And the whole purpose of light strike design of that light strike setup is to give you a responsive feel, all while keeping the shoe lightweight. And the Dame 7s have a really balanced cushioning setup, and the insoles do have some sort of pattern on there that actually somewhat added to that comfort, giving these a little bit softer feel than what I felt from the Don 3s. But the Don 3s definitely did improve on their comfort level from last year's model. So moving on to the upper, you have almost the exactly same materials at play for both of these shoes, which is just going to be some cheaper textiles, but that does help keep the shoe lightweight and breathable all at once. And then for the support, there is a little bit better lateral containment in the Dame 7s. The Don 3s have some heel slippage problems, but nothing crazy, but it is there just a little bit. And then looking at the bottom of these shoes, kind of focusing more on the traction, you can see that we have two different traction patterns going on. So the Dame 7s are kind of following more of a herringbone look with those sharp arrows in there, and they did play very well on the court. And then switching it over and checking out the Don issue 3, they did keep the same kind of general look from last year's model. They just tweaked it just a little bit to fix some of the inconsistencies that did show up on the Don issue 2 for traction. So it is a solid option for both indoor and outdoor use, but, you know, honestly, both of these are going to be good for that, since they are made up of 100% rubber and pretty durable rubber at that on that outsole. But both of these shoes are also going to be a true to size fit, so at least you don't have to worry about making any changes to accommodate for that Adidas sizing, which is always nice. So for the final ratings, I love all the colorways for the Dame 7s that have been coming out, but I'm also just a bigger fan of that design for those in general too. So I do like the appearance a little bit better. And then for cushion, these do have the same type of cushioning setup going on, but the Dame 7s do feel a little bit better to play in, even though the Don 3 did take a step forward from last year's model. That is something to be keeping an eye on. But for the materials, we are looking at, you know, some pretty comparable stuff in that area. So there isn't really a clear-cut choice in my eyes. So we're going to resort to a tie on that section. While I am going to lean towards the Dame 7s for support, because I do feel the Don 3s did take a pretty decent step back in that area, just compared to the Don 2s even. And then for traction, while the Dons did fix some of those pre-existing issues, the Dame 7s just kind of feature the more solid design that does play just a little bit better. So that will result in the Dame 7s kind of walking away the winner of this battle. But with both of these shoes retailing for the same price at $110, I do believe that the Dame 7s, you know, it's just a better shoe for kind of equal value. There really isn't like a clear-cut weakness on that model aside from, you know, them not having the most premium materials on that upper, but, you know, neither shoe is going to wow you in that area. And then just in case you are interested, you know, in a little bit more of an in-depth review for each shoe, we do kind of have individual shoe reviews live right now for each pair where I go deeper into both of these models. So feel free to check that out. But that does pretty much wrap up our performance comparison for the Dame 7 Say Cheese. And of course, the Don 3 issue Say Cheese as well. So thank you guys for taking some time to watch. If you're interested in purchasing either of these shoes, we are going to be leaving some links in the description below. So feel free to check that out. And then last, just go ahead and feel free to leave a comment below if you like this review, or just let us know any shoe that you want us to check out next. But until next review, I'm Landon from Shoewear. Peace.